November 22nd, the day we all recall from 20 years ago, the day we vividly remember what we were doing when the shock of the assassination of John F. Kennedy traumatized the world. For many, it was the death of a dream, the end of a new era of hope. At his inauguration in January of 1961, Kennedy urged his fellow Americans, "Ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country." It set the tone for a new spirit in America that carried him through his darkest hours, like the Cuban Missile Crisis. His magic charmed the world. There was that day in West Berlin when he seemed to speak for the entire free world, when he said, "Ich bin ein Berliner." Then in November 1963, it was all over.
Even before the gates of Arlington National Cemetery had opened to the public, early on the anniversary morning of John Kennedy's death, close family members held a private vigil at the late president's graveside. They left roses at the eternal flame. Later, the 18th century Holy Trinity Catholic Church in Washington's Georgetown district, which Kennedy attended as senator and president, was location for a commemorative service. President Reagan led a guest list of the powerful from America's past and its present, though it was really a service for the dozens of members of the burgeoning Kennedy family. The widow Jacqueline was absent in Hyannisport, Massachusetts, with the matriarch of the Kennedys, the 93-year-old mother, Rose. They thought of his death, but spoke of his life. Kennedy's daughter, Carolyn, now nearly 26, read from the assassinated president's speeches. As Ted Kennedy, the only survivor of four brothers, spoke poignantly of the failings of 20 years ago, he seemed to be offering advice for today's American leadership.
There were missteps and mistakes, but for him, saving lives and the national interest was more important than saving face. He took responsibility for the Bay of Pigs, and how much I wish he had been there to reconsider our role in Vietnam.
Throughout the day, hundreds of people, many not born when Kennedy died, flocked to the graveside to pray, or more often to stand silently reflecting on nearly a quarter century past. Veterans of the Green Berets, the elite army unit started by Kennedy, placed a wreath as an army trumpeter sounded the last post. Craig Oliver, CTV News in Washington.
Is it that 20 years later, there is still a lingering sense of shock, of sadness, and of loss? John Kennedy was president for only 3 years. His legislative achievements were insignificant and his foreign policy record spotty at best. Yet not only was his memory swiftly elevated to near sainthood, but even 2 decades later, the psychic trauma of his murder is still not entirely healed. Part of the reason stems from the sense of collective shame that society felt. And apparently it wasn't generous enough to tolerate in its presence a man who constantly challenged us to rise above ancient prejudices and outworn ideas. Lee Harvey Oswald shot him, but we all felt some of the guilt. Part of it stems also from the sadness of youthful promise unfulfilled. Kennedy, in a way, symbolized all the young life extinguished in this century by violence of one kind or another. But most of all, it was the feeling of glowing optimism that Kennedy somehow imparted to his times and was lost when he died. He made us feel better about ourselves, and he fostered a belief that things not only could, but probably would.
Scene, because I just flown in that moment. I just arrived in Dallas and stumbled into this thing. And so I got to a phone and phoned the news desk and say, "Look, you can forget about it, I'm here." And had them telling me all about what I was doing because they had been watching it on television. And I hadn't, till that moment, been aware that the cameras were recording everything live.
We'll have a complete interview with Peter Worthington tracing his memories of that time later in Night Beat.